We got the Codfather.
Yo, what's up?
Codfather, aka, do you want to, people to know your other
We'll just
name?
keep it Godfather.
Okay. See, because me, I'm opposite. Everyone calls me Mikey now. And a little spoiler alert, I'm going to be changing the name of a lot of my stuff. So that's,
Really?
but like my gamer
Really?
tag's Mikey, and a lot of my other shit's Mikey. So it's time to change. It's not going to be to Mikey's because then to Smiley's might sue me. And we don't want that because she's slowly becoming a bigger
I like her
sensation.
name.
Her name?
Yeah,
I liked
her
it
name's
too.
like.
See, people were like, "Oh, you copied her and stuff," and I'm like, "Well, I was inspired. I was inspired by Smiley. I wanted say I can't use Mikey, the guy who has the Mikey gamer tag. He doesn't even use it. I hate those people. They have
There's
like
always those
they have
people.
Bob and Jason. They have all these." Single names, you know. I actually ran into Samantha once
Whoa.
on a Black Ops, and I'm like, "What?" And I clicked their name, and sure enough, fucking 10 years old or 12 years old, the GT. And but this, the guy who has Mikey, he's not even using it. Like, what the
Well,
hell,
too
man?
bad. Stay
Shame.
Salty. Stay Salty is Mew. Is Sally's probably taken Sally Mew. Wait, you got your name though,
Yeah,
Almu. You
Ally
got it.
Mew. I try to claim it as fast as possible,
On
so too
everything.
bad, suckers.
You could claim it on all the sites, MySpace and Insta, Pornhub, everything. You don't want no one mistaking you.
Blackpeoplemeet.com.
Oh, dude, that someone had my name. Someone had YouTube Dude on some. I don't know what it was. It was a racist website or something. I sure as fuck, it wasn't me. And it goes back to like 2003 or. Something really long before my YouTube channel was even around, or maybe it's around the same time. I don't know, it's really old, but it's not me. And this guy, I think it's racist. It was something where this guy was agitating people because someone came on my channel and they said, "Hey, are you the guy from the fucking the KKK forums?" And I'm like, "What? No." And then I Googled the guy. Now, if you Google my YouTube dude, it shows my channel. But back then, it showed all this guy that was just being a really nasty, nasty person on the internet. He's getting fights and saying he was gonna hack people and shit. I'm like, dude. And then another time, back when I had like 1,000 subs, some guy pretended to be me, and then he took my name on some different forums and he's saying, "Hey guys, if you want hacks, be sure and message me," because he was trying to get me in trouble with like Activision or something. So yeah, that's it. You guys ever have that? Codfather, I've seen people with the Codfather GT though. That's kind of a
Yeah, what's it called? At first I didn't, but then out of nowhere, I saw it a lot. I don't know. I still kept mine. I don't know. I liked it.
what?
It's X Codfather 4X, I guess. The X part is kind of like a joke to me. It's not really like, you know how people have like XX blah blah XX and
That's
stuff like
usually
that?
determines how legit you are. Because when I
Exactly.
see more X's in a gamer tag, I'm like, I'm not gonna mess with that dude.
Yeah. And I have X Codfather 4X. The 4 basically kind of just represents Call of Duty, where, like, when I got really into Call of Duty, which was Call of Duty 4.
Call of
So.
Duty 4, that was a siren call
Good times. Good
for
times.
young boys
And
everywhere.
girls.
And a couple girls, I guess, if they exist, like unicorns right now.
Hey.
Do we do proper interest? We got Mew here, obviously, and then we got Codfather. So, what else do you play? Is that all you play, or what? What
No,
happened?
no, no. This is the ironic thing. I don't play Call of Duty very often anymore. I actually play more GTA now, and that's actually what most of my videos are on and stuff like that. But I have been playing. I still play them, but I don't really upload them. Like, I was just playing Black Ops 3 beta, like literally just before this podcast.
Nice. How are you
So,
finding it?
oh man, it is. I'm proud of Vaughn. I'm proud of him. I really like it. Guns are great. Maps are beautiful, and gameplay is really nice. And I don't know, I'm just having a good time with it.
That's good, 'cause me and Mikey are left in the dust for now.
Yeah, unfortunately. But
Yeah, 'cause they betrayed us. They
No,
betrayed
you
us.
mean because someone was flashing a lot of money and they took the opportunity, which I don't blame them. You know, it's
I
only
was actually
holidays.
prepared for this for like a very like before Advanced Warfare even came out. I actually thought up of a theory. I was like, you know, PlayStation's doing really well. I'm pretty sure. Don't they have like a contract that lasts like 3 or 5 years or something like that? And I was like, I'm pretty sure I remember reading an article saying that it was going to end somewhere around this time. And I was like, you know what? I think they're actually going to go with PlayStation this time. So and on top of that, Activision's been having like ridiculously good like relationship with Destiny. Mm-hmm. And all that stuff with PlayStation, and so I was like, you know, I think they would actually switch. And there was all kinds of rumors, and I was like, you know what, I'm not gonna get an Xbox One until they tell us which console is getting the exclusive rights to the multiplayer first or whatever. So I was like, if Xbox gets a DLC first, then I'm getting an Xbox One. If not, then I guess I don't have to get one at the moment. I still plan on getting one eventually, because I like having both consoles, just so I don't miss out on anything.
Yeah, but see, I think they're regretting it now, though, because more people, I'm talking about Destiny, more people mm-hmm. are on Xbox than on the Destiny version. And
that's hilarious.
And that is interesting. Destiny players that are on Xbox, they're better than PlayStation.
How do you
players.
Know? Okay,
I know this.
Those are fighting words.
Yeah, I knew they'd be fighting words. And if you go to Destiny Tracker, this is a website that what I used to use it for is you type in someone's gamer tag and you could see how good they are, or you could just check out your stats. And I'll get into my stats, because they're not so bad, just saying. If you go to the top 10 leaderboards and you click on both, bam, what do you see? And I'll put a link for you guys. I'll have a link to this in the description. I'm putting a link in this.
I can imagine people still crying.
Bam! Look at this. People look at the top 10 players in Destiny. This is for both platforms. Look at this. X-Bone. And then finally, at number 7, some Mac M, who gives a fuck? X-Bone. There's one PS4 nerd in there.
That is very interesting.
That's facts, son.
Not from the US either.
Well, people still cry no matter what.
Yeah, the one PlayStation yeah. nerd is on where is he from? What is that? What flag is that? Who cares? It's not American. So you guys can check out the link. You can also sort by X-Bone. You can type in your name. Like, let's see me, since we're already here. Let's type in my GT to Mikey's, and what do we got? Top 5% in kills.
Jeez.
Yeah. Come at me, bros. My KDR is 1.2. My win percentage is 46%. Thanks a lot, actually. That's a lot in part to streaming. Because whenever I stream, I usually invite people. And I got a bunch of sweaty people that are in the stream, usually like 90% of the time. We hardly ever lose. That's the best part about being a streamer. You just bam, who wants to play? Boom, come on in, and then we wreck shop. But hey, real quick though, do you know what Ting is?
No, what is Ting?
As I just randomly bring it up mid conversation. All right, as you know, I'm broke as fuck. But how do I maintain a mobile phone? How do I have an iPhone 5? And that is because I use Ting, Mikey. Ting.com, and I used them for months before I said anything to anybody. And that's been over a year. Guess what my month's bill was for my iPhone 5? Take a wild guess.
$100.
No, it was $16.
What?
Yep.
What?
And I actually will have a screenshot on my Twitter. If you don't believe me, you guys already know. If you've been a long time listener, you already know. $16, and I believe my average, actually, I believe that's my average. 16, sometimes at 15. Sometimes, if I'm sending a lot of dick pics, it's 18. But it all varies. Mikey.ting.com. They'll hook you up with a nice credit. That's a nice credit. It's like $25. Last month, they surprised me. It was actually a greater amount. But at the very least, it's $25. It helps you. It helps me. They also sell used phones there. That's where I got my used iPhone 5 that I use today. Special link down below. Special link in the description. It helps all of us, mostly me. And let's get back to that cool thing we were just talking about.
Mikey, since we're on the subject of Destiny, is there something you would like to talk about? Is there any Destiny news that people have to learn about? Let's get this out of the way, please.
Well, there was actually a lot, but I'll only tell you some major thing? Because I know you don't give a rat's ass. Codfather, do you play this at all? How are you into Destiny? Do you like it? Are you hardcore?
I wouldn't say super hardcore, but I do have quite a lot of hours on it. I have like random bursts of like, you know, every once in a while I'll just be like, I play it for like day in, day out for like 2-3 weeks, and then I'll just kind of leave it for a little bit. Then I'll come back and just demolish it, like just play 24/7 and stuff like that. So, like, but I keep up with all the all the news and stuff.
How many hours you got? I wonder if the set tells you. Like, I'm trying to figure that part out. That's what I want to know.
I want to say around like the 250, maybe.
I wonder if this, like, this site has so...
The average, I hear the average is insane for Destiny players.
I'm trying to see. That's the one thing I cannot find on this site. And maybe I'm looking... Oh, here we go. No, this doesn't make any sense. 2 days played. That has to be my alt character.
I thought I saw somewhere it said that this, like, the average Destiny player had like 100 hours or something like that.
Okay. Oh, here we go. Oh, here we go. Okay, you have to click on the characters. So my primary character has 27 days.
Jeez.
27. That's one character.
So you're on the no life status.
Okay, but hold up. We're not done yet, sons. Oh, we're not done. That's one character.
Oh, gosh.
Plus 7 days. Okay, 27 plus 7. That's the second character plus the last character. 2 days. Okay. So 27 plus 7 plus 2 equals a lot. It equals a lot. A lot. Stay in school, kids. So, yeah, dude, over 35 fucking days. That's like up there with Call of Duty. So I like the game. I do take breaks. So I take long breaks. I'll take like a 5-day break. I will play it once a week to do a raid or some shit like that. I got to stay in the mix of it.
I leave it for months and then come back and play it for like 2 weeks and then leave it for months.
But aren't you playing other FPS shooters though in the meantime?
Yeah, pretty much.
You have to though if you want to keep your edge. Mm-hmm. You gotta play some type of shooting game. Titanfall, fucking Halo Reach, whatever it is. You gotta have that eye hand coordination. And some people say, "Wow, like whenever a new game comes out, wow, how are you good at this already?" I mean, it's the basic skill of pointing and shooting. That never goes away. That's basic. That's basic skill. You got to memorize like the different features and the different specials and different things like that. But what's the word I'm looking for? You know, the basic idea of an FPS shooter: move your thumbs, point to the thing, pull the trigger, bam. That never goes away, right? Right.
Just like that.
What else? Oh. So we didn't talk about the new shit. We need to get over. So what was really big? What would you guys even care about? Let's see. Because I already made a separate vid that talks about the top 10 things that I liked. So you guys can check that out in the description, because I don't want to bore everybody with this. They doubled the vault space.
Oh.
It's 72 weapons. I mean, I sure mean doesn't give a rat's ass about that, but yeah, we got more vaults blaze.
I am so interested. This makes my panties wet.
What else? They added lots of cool little things, and they kind of basically refined the game. So now it feels like we've been playing a beta this whole time for this whole year, and now it's taking shape. Is it perfect? Hell nah. Because I've been doing, okay, so there's this raid thing. You know what the raid is, right?
Mm-hmm.
Crota's Revenge. I don't know what the hell's name is.
What raids are.
I'm over this raid. This raid has melted my brain. Basically, once a week, you get 3 chances to get a very, very rare item that has a 5% or less percent chance of dropping. Okay? That is a cheap way to extend gameplay, but fuck it. I fell for it. And it's to get a cool weapon. You need a cool thing to make a cool weapon, and I want to get it. And the thing is that I've been trying for months since the DLC came out, and then I stopped, and then I started up again. And I haven't got it. And it's very frustrating. Slim got it. Slim got the Crux of Crota. our friend Miss Slim. I invited a viewer, a random viewer got it, but I haven't. And so that weapon that is so rare, it's going to be obsolete next month. Jeez. And I don't know how to feel about that. It's called the Necrochasm, if you guys want to Google it. It's called the Necrochasm, and they're going to buff. This is what's very bizarre. I do not understand a lot of the things that Bungie does. I just don't get it. So the super rare item, they're going to buff it because it actually sucks. It's actually really, really crappy. All
right.
Okay. So they're going to buff it. I think next week it's going to be pretty badass in Crucible. And then What's going to happen? So now the new DLC drops September 15th, the Taken King for Destiny. And that weapon becomes obsolete because new better shit is happening. So I don't
know. Might get me back into it.
So why would you want the weapon if it's going to be really bad in the long run?
Because It's fucking rare and I want it.
Then wouldn't there be more rare shit that's going to drop from the new DLC?
You know, right? You just don't understand me, okay? You play League or whatever that
weird game is. I am not on that no life path, so.
Right. How many days played do you have on League of Legends?
So I only play after work, so it's not even that long. Probably I'll play like 3 hours per day. 5 if
total.
I'm off.
Total.
Total. Total? Oh, shit. There was a website for that. Total hours.
Yeah, go type in your GT.
League
for League of Legends. Yeah.
But they only count on one server. So this is only on like NA, not the beta server or EUS.
I know, because you play on the other one whenever you go across the pond.
Okay, so I am waiting for it to tell me.
Mm-hmm.
It says I've played 62.4 days.
60 days? What are you making fun of me for playing Destiny, okay? You just don't understand
the things. It has been out longer, too, right?
Yeah, it's been out longer, too. All and right. It's the span of, 3 years that I've been playing?
All right, whatever. You get your logic out of here.
Wait, but you know what's funny? Like, the Codfather did bring up a funny point that he doesn't play COD as much, and neither do all three of us. And we used to post Call of Duty stuff.
Yep.
Is that not interesting? That's cool.
Well, and... Okay, go ahead.
I was going to say, Advanced Warfare hasn't been out too long either, and we've already, strayed away from it.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's because it wasn't all that great, and it's kind of annoying.
Yeah, but there's always, there's so many people who hype it up, just normal people, and then when I look at all the YouTubers that are posting up stuff, they're already on Black Ops 3's dick, you know?
Well, yeah, it's the same thing every year.
Mm-hmm.
It was like that with Ghosts. Probably the least liked Call of Duty, and they were just so fucking hyped for it. And then
I was curious about that. I wasn't sure why they were so I was hearing a lot of there was a couple of people that were like, this game is terrible, don't buy it, that were like, you know, some big YouTubers. I can't remember exactly which names, but most of them were like, yeah, this is amazing, this is this and that and stuff like that. I from what I saw, I wasn't interested in it, and I never got hyped for it, but I did buy it and then play it, give it a month, and I was like, done. Maybe not even that, to be honest. It was
Yeah, I think Ghost lasted 3 months, around the 2 month mark.
Uh-huh.
And then, yeah. And then what was worse, that's pretty bad. It died after 3 months. It was dead. But The DLC was good, though. The maps were good.
And I did get one of them.
Yeah, they had a lot of cool stuff. You could be Mickey Myers. You could be the Predator. They had weird things. Like, they had the Day of the Dead map. And then you could be the guy with
their guns were good, too.
The guy with the guns. Huh?
Yeah. Their guns were good, too. The gun DLCs they came with?
Yeah, it was just the stock maps, dude, were so horrible. Ugh. Horrible. And then you die so fat. Like, they have really huge, big-ass maps that came with the game. And then you died in 2 bullets. So then you're doing a lot of running around and searching for people. It was so bad. Mm-hmm. And to top it off, there was no ground war available for those big-ass maps on the basic old gen.
Oh, yeah.
They did not think that thing through.
That was a setup for failure.
And then so all the casuals were like, well, this game sucks. And then you were stuck with like hardcore people who were like, well, I might as well play the game. I got the season pass. But see, the thing is, they made up for it in the map. So they made almost all the DLC is small to mid-size, and it's all colorful because colorful and interesting because they fucked up with the defaults, which are all gray and boring and just stupid. So it's a very interesting...
I like the way you said that.
It's a very interesting COD because you will have fun with the DLC. So anyways, mm-hmm. What was worse than that, though? Remember Titanfall? That shit died after 3 weeks.
Oh, my God. I think it died after the demo,
honestly. Yeah, it died for me after the demo.
Well, that was like that for me for Destiny. After the demo, I was just like, this game is just meh. Sorry.
I've never seen a shooter die so quick. I couldn't believe it. It was, that game was so bad that they released all the DLC for free. So I kind of want to try it again just because all the DLC is free and, you know, just rent it and like
shoot. It was on sale for $10 like multiple times and I still didn't purchase it. I was like, nope, I'm not going to play it. I remember when the demo came out, at first I was loving it. I went like 33 in like 3 deaths. Then I look at the scoreboard and it says like 29 bot kills. I had like 3 actual kills. Like, wait, what? And I was like, no, I'm done. Just killing bots left and right.
Yeah, I was a bot killer. They were so focused on trying to make people feel good. The feel good bots. You like them though, right? Mew, you like the feel good bots.
I mean, they were okay, but I didn't like hate Destiny, but I didn't like praise it either. You know, the one person that I remember that was praising it, actually two YouTubers that I obviously watch and know, like Drifter. Probably till this day, still loved it. He was posting content for the longest time, and so did Miss 5000 Watts.
For Titanfall?
For Titanfall. And yeah. This is like when we all pieced the hell out.
Yeah, they're still trying. They're trying. Me, I pieced out. I was like, I was going to do my gold camo series, and then one day I was just like, yeah, what is my life? This game sucks. I went back to Black Ops. And then Advanced Warfare came out, and it was... It's all right. People just didn't like the movie. We talk about this shit every single week. Let's move on. How about Gears of War Ultimate Edition?
I'm interested.
The Mad World. Did anyone see the Mad World trailer, though?
No, not yet.
No? Okay, so you probably didn't care enough. Well, I have a link to it. And it looks like they're trying to capitalize on our nostalgia.
Oh, yeah.
Because what they did was, you may need to turn down the volume. They recreated the original Gears of War trailer with the playing Mad World.
Yes.
Do you remember the original?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I remember that one.
So I think they replaced the old graphics with new graphics. So, I mean, that's kind of what it is, though, right? It's a remake? Is that what they're doing?
Yeah, they are remaking the trilogy.
Oh, okay, so when you buy what is Gears of War Ultimate? What the fuck is it? You get all the games? Does anyone even know?
Yeah, I think it's all the games. Yeah, I believe
you get
them all. All 3.
We are pros here. Okay, well, let's find out what it is. We're gonna help.
Is it all 3 or is it the first one?
I think it's all 3.
Gears of War Ultimate Edition, Xbox One exclusive. No, you don't say. For Xbox only. Just the reimagining stuff. Oh, it's 60 FPS.
Yeah,
60 FPS. Oh, here we go. It has been painstakingly remastered in 1080p. Can the Xbox even output 1080p? I don't think it can. 1080p modernized for Xbox with 60 FPS compared to multiplayer. That's nice. And new content, including 5 campaign chapters, never released on Xbox.
So
it's kind of like a reimagining, a remake, and a...
So kind of like the Halo, like, series coming out, like the Master Chief Collection, mm-hmm. You can replay it through.
That's what it sounds multiplayer. That's what it sounds like. That used to be the scene back in the day. It used to be competitive, fucking art. Miss Violent, she has a damn Gears tattoo. Like, that was a hard... Mm-hmm. There's a lot of Gears tattoos.
Cold I remember Gears 1. Hardcore, people competed, tournaments, popular, but... It died. It just peaked.
Google Gears of War tattoo. You're going to see an ass ton, dude. There is a lot. Some guys want to back. I mean, it's a badass looking logo, regardless. You know, when you're an old man, you'd be like, "Oh, that's just a cool skull with the gear." Like, it looks, it's a cool logo, right? So,
yeah.
Who cares if you don't play the game? There's some badass tattoos, actually. I mean, it's a very cool logo. Well, that's damn. Some guy has a big ass one across his heart. Look at that! Oh, you see it on Google results.
Yep.
Good lord! Jeez. Yeah, just Google Gears of War tattoo. Oh my god, this guy has a whole back piece.
This guy's got it on his ankle, on his hand.
What happens when you go to Call of Duty tattoo? I've seen a few.
You think there's a Destiny tattoo?
There's not as many. Oh my god. A ghost tattoo. Actually, though, you can just say, oh, it's a cool ghost face. Oh my god, this guy actually put Call of Duty Ghost. He put the full-on logo on.
Really?
I remember seeing this. Hold on. I will show it to you.
Oh, god.
Link on Charlie Intel. Look at this fool. Devoted COD fan gets tattoo of Ghost in Black Ops 2.
Oh my god, he is like a walking billboard. And they kind of look funky. My god. They don't even look that great, if you know what I mean.
Looking at the comments, rip chance to get laid.
basically, imagine the Call of Duty Ghost cover and having that put in your body.
Yeah, but it's not even exactly nice. It looks like some kid stenciled over the stuff and put on someone as a tattoo.
it's not the best shading. Wow. I wonder the date he did it. It had to have been before the game came out. Now, I like Black Ops 2, but I don't know if I want to get there. And, like, look at the logo. It's all, like, really, really super shady.
Mm-hmm.
Like, shaded in. I don't know. It's just, I can't even imagine getting a Call of Duty tattoo. So, anyways.
Have a Destiny tattoo.
Yes. So yes, there is Destiny tattoos.
No, and, so would you get a Destiny tattoo?
No. No. It had maybe like a little Mario tattoo. Like, that'd be cool. Oh, if you type in Destiny tattoo, you're going to get a bunch of chicks with Destiny. You have to type in Destiny game tattoo, and you actually see a lot. Oh my god, this guy had a game controller tatted on his hands. See, a lot of this stuff, though, is not timeless. Like, the Mario Bro. Like, it's been around for over a decade, so that's kind of timeless. You know what I mean? Like, I could see having Mario or Pac-Man, like one of those old things. Dude, there's some freaky tattoos when you Google stuff. Anyways.
Oh my god, like this one. This Ryu one.
The face one?
No, this Ryu. I put Destiny, the game Ryu tattoo.
Oh, I saw that one.
<That's>... I was like, what the hell? That actually looks cool.
It looks very weird, though, from that angle. All right, so we're in an audio podcast talking about things that people can't even see, that you use Google for.
Well, I put the link down so you can link it there so they can see what I'm laughing at.
Who here is looking forward to... we didn't finish talking about Black Ops. People just want me to talk about Black Ops 3. Am I going to play it? I get this question every freaking day in my chat room.
Are you going to play it? Of course he will when he can get the
beta. I have millions and millions of Call of Duty views. My most viewed video is over a million, 2 million. I don't know how many views. It's a Call of Duty video. I have built my channel off of Call of Duty. I've been playing since Call of Duty 3. When that come out. Anyone know? And Call of Duty 3
during the dinosaur
release date. November 7, 2006. I've been playing since 2006.
Ooh.
I play Call of Duty at least a couple times a week. Even though I don't like Advanced Warfare, it's all right. I still play it. I still stream it. I'll play Ghosts. Okay. Will I play the beta of Black Ops 3, the latest game of the game that I've been playing for almost a decade? What do you think? Oh my fucking god. So yeah, and when I've watched a little bit of gameplay. I watched this guy Hutch, I watched him stream. Watched him for like 20 minutes and I'm like, oh cool. I'll just wait till I play it. So I don't even know what's in the game. I know there's a Titan Smash and a Golden Gun and there's self-revive. So it's like they copied a lot of shit from Destiny. So I should be right at home. So, but and those are supers that anyone can get at any time. It's just they basically copied and pasted the Destiny shit. So that's gonna suck having your you're trying to get a nuke or something, and then your streak gets ended by some nerd who got a hand me down. And what's funny is Vaughn is actually backtracking on what he said. If you look at old Black Ops 2 videos before it came out, people were saying, "So is there going to be support streaks?" And he goes, "Nope, we're not into that. No hand me downs, no gimmies." And what do we got now? Now we got the gimmies. That's like a new thing to give people.
Yeah.
So I don't know, but there's probably going to be modes where that's not allowed. I would assume, like the competitive mode.
I would assume, because we got these specialists that are just insane, that lets you, like, you're basically like a god on the field for like a moment, and you'll be able to like for example, there's this one where you get a pistol. It's one shot, one hit, one kill.
Yeah, the golden gun.
That's so crazy. That's like Destiny.
That's the golden gun. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't even want to know its real name. That's the golden gun.
Annihilate.
I will always call it the golden gun, and I will always call the Titan Smash the Derp Smash. I don't give a fuck what the real name is. That is what it's going to be called. Maybe I'll include the real name for tagging purposes, but I will never acknowledge it by whatever stupid name Char gave it.
Yeah, it's pretty insane. You can even shoot through the wall and get people.
Cool. Well, can't wait to try it. I like Hunter's my favorite class, so I cannot wait to use the golden gun in Black Ops 3. It looks nice. Looks like Black Ops. Just looks like an updated version of Black Ops 2. It looks very, very good. So, moving on. Who here is interested in Rainbow Six Siege?
I saw the gameplay. I just don't know how often I'd play it and stuff like that, but I heard they're redoing it and everything.
Did you ever play any Rainbow Sixes? Do you like Search? It's kind of like Search and Destroy in a way.
Yeah. I've played some of them.
Search and Rescue. You know, that type of no respawn.
Mm-hmm. The gameplay was actually pretty cool to see, though.
Well, it was supposed to release October.
Yep.
October 13th. Nope. Not gonna happen. It's gonna come out December. They need more time.
Mm-hmm.
December. It has been delayed to December 1st, 2015. The game had been previously due to come out October 13th. The closed beta is still due to begin on September 24th. And they said I'm gonna get access, so hopefully I'll be streaming that soon.
Yeah, they got some feedback, and now they're, you know, trying to improve it, so that's nice to see that they're willing to push it in times like November and October. Those are pretty crucial times. They're pushing it back a little bit to improve the game. It's nice to see.
Yeah, I don't mind. Look what happened to Halo.
Yep. Exactly. Yep.
It could also be because of these major releases, so...
Yeah, true.
The revised release date means that Rainbow Six will now release after all of this year's major first-person shooters. It was previously been due to arrive ahead of Call of Duty Black Ops 3, Star Wars Battlefront, and Halo 5 Guardians, which are all due to launch in October. So maybe they're like, do you want to fuck with the big boys? They're probably thinking, let's see which ones fail. People will want a new game, and that's when we come in. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
So, Halo 5 Guardians, dude, that has an insane amount of pre-orders. I wonder if they updated the thing. We usually go to VG Games. Here we go.
Yeah.
Let's see if they've updated it.
Mikey, you're right about that, though. Like, do you remember how Watch Dogs, I believe it got pushed back and no other game was really out at the time?
Wasn't that like a month just before it came out, too? That it got pushed back or something?
I think so.
Yeah, these numbers are pretty old. These are still the same numbers, so they're probably much higher. So this is back in July. 323,000 people pre-order Halo 5 Guardians, even after the mess that was Master Chief.
That is crazy.
They didn't learn their fucking lesson. They're like, fuck it. They're going to do good this time. And we're pre-ordering. So it's probably 400K or something. That is insane.
Ooh, I see my game Kingdom Hearts on the list there.
I know. Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah, we talk about this one or two podcasts already. And Black Ops.
How do I remember that?
Black Ops 3 for Xbox has 465K. And Black Ops 3 for PS4 has 330K. Mm-hmm. And so it's probably more. Like, what were they doing? How can you just flip like that? Like, you build up this big audience for Xbox being the home of Call of Duty, and then you just flip the script just like that? Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? So, yeah, I'm not buying a PS4. You're not going to sell a console that way. So you can count me out, man. just like Destiny. They thought it would work. No one's going to invest a year and then all of a sudden flip the script. So I think that's why they're offering, just to go back to Destiny, they are offering this thing called a Spark of Light. I think they're wanting to cater to people who want to buy a PS4. And they're like, okay, so you invested all those hours on Xbox. We can't import your character, but we can give you Spark of Light. And what it does is it bumps you up to level 25 so you can immediately start playing.
Really?
But you lose all your shit. You lose all your stats. You lose all your stuff. You got to get all new friends. Like, that's dumb. Those console year-long console exclusives, thumbs up if that was the worst idea ever. So dumb. I'm never going to fall for that shit. So I have a link. It's the site is called VG Charts. Google it. Link down below. But they haven't updated in a while, so I'm really surprised that Halo 5 Guardians got. There's a lot of hype for it.
That's crazy.
I'm shocked. I thought Halo died. There's
a lot of people who grew up on the Xbox, Mikey, yeah. And they do not give a fuck. They want to know what happens to Master Chief, and I want to know what happens to him because I don't exactly just play for multiplayer. We actually play for campaign. Unlike Call of Duty, no offense.
Okay, so it's Halo 5 Guardians. Is Master Chief in it?
He should be, because in Halo 4, a lot of stuff happened. And let's just say the cliffhanger was super crazy, and I want to know what happens next.
So it's a Halo 4... Is a Halo 4 campaign good?
Yeah, it's really fun.
All right, I'll rent it. I'll check it out. And if it sucks...
You can play with three other people.
Oh, okay. All right. I'll rent it at the very bare minimum.
You know, you're the only person I know who says they'll rent it.
Yeah. Well, I use
it. That's kind of funny.
No, well, because I use an online service, which I will no longer promote. But
because
they're little bitches. But I use an online gaming rental service. Hey, wasn't there someone that we used to partner with that maybe might want to partner with us again?
It was for used games.
Oh, for used games? Or I'll get it used. I am buying that shit new. All right, let's move on. We're at the halfway point. Wait, what else? Any other new gaming stuff?
I don't know,
What games are you looking forward to? Mew, what's your top three games you cannot wait to play? And go.
Kingdom Hearts 3, which is also going to be for Xbox One. And second one is probably... The next, I guess, what's that? The Mass Effect series, whatever it's going to be called.
Yeah, they haven't titled, but it's Mass Effect something.
And my third is a tie. I want to play the Mirror's Edge sequel and the Star Wars Battlefront there.
Oh, Mass Effect Andromeda.
Yeah, that.
That's what it's called. And it takes place in the universe, but it does not deal with Shepard or
all those people. It's going to be some other person that you'll be.
Mm-hmm. So no Black Ops 3, huh?
I feel like Black Ops 3 is one of those, like, you're going to do it anyway. It's a Fast and Furious of the summer.
Yeah, I wasn't even going to include that as in my top three because I was just going to get it anyway.
Yeah, it's a fall movie that we all go see. It's going to be some love romantic movie with all the big stars in it. I don't know how to explain it.
I don't know about that, but so you can go to midnight release, wait in line?
Nope.
No.
I'm going to probably wait for it to be on sale and be a Christmas noob.
What?
I don't know.
Aww. Yeah. It's fun when you play day one and you see the lobby full of noobs.
Oh, God.
That's crazy.
Maybe. We'll see.
Usually I get the game early and then I max level and then I go in there and just beat up everybody. That's pretty fun. That's what I like doing. Codfather, what are your top three new game picks? And go.
I was not prepared for this, but Kingdom Hearts is definitely one of them, except it's not going to come this year, is it, right?
I don't know. I have no interest in that game. I've never played it, never cared.
Well, it was a really great game. Another game, I guess, I'm interested in Battlefront, I guess. And I'm very interested in Fallout 4. The funny thing is I've never actually played any Fallout in my entire life, but the trailer and the gameplay actually really surprised me. So I was like, you know, this looks like something I could really sink some hours in. So I was like,
I'll go for it. Yeah, yeah. You're going to sink a lot of hours. Good thing for you. I do believe they include Fallout 3 with it.
Oh, yeah.
So that is a crap ton of gameplay. If you're looking for
a quick question?
So,
would you recommend New Vegas? I just got that on Steam. Is that worth playing? I don't know. It was really cheap at the time when I got it.
New Vegas is like... It's not good, it's not bad. It's just more Fallout, in my opinion. More of the Fallout universe.
So would you recommend I play Fallout 3 instead of New Vegas?
That's what I would recommend. Fallout 3 is just so good. The music is good. If you see something in the back in far off in the distance, you can actually go there and explore it.
That's crazy.
And what's crazy is that it's on console, not PC, so like it's kind of limited, but it's still good.
Yeah, I didn't like play any Fallout was because I didn't think it would be my type of game until I saw the new Fallout. The reason, like with Fallout 3, there was a that slow motion thing, I didn't understand it, I guess. I didn't look into it enough. I thought that was all you can actually do, you know, where you aim at their head and stuff like that, and then it automatically goes. And on top of that was kind of the wasteland kind of vibe to it, but I actually don't think I would mind it anymore.
Yeah, yeah, you're going to like the VATS, because these enemies, they're really strong. When you go to other places, and the VATS is like... slows down time and lets you... They're going to change it, though. They're going to make it a little bit more balanced. But it has a limited amount of juice. So you can't just do that zoom in and fucking snipe them on all their little crit spots. You can't do that anymore. I believe they're still going to come at you very, very slowly, but they won't be frozen. Because right now, you freeze them, and then you pick where you want to shoot them, and then it does it. And then after that, you're stuck with using free aim, I guess you want to call it free aim. And then you have to have really good weapons and stuff. And so it's kind of like, I don't know, have you played Skyrim or any RPG?
Oh, yeah.
You play Skyrim? Okay, well, then it's kind of like that, then, I guess. Skyrim with guns, I believe, was a popular quote. People
always say that, Skyrim with...
All right, cool. And I don't know. I've answered this question so many times. I guess Black Ops 3, Mass Effect, and the Star Wars one. But I'm going to play everything, so it really doesn't matter.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Oh, really random, dude. I got to show you. We hardly ever talk about current events. Check this shit out. This is free. I wonder what you think about this.
Uh-oh.
Watch this video, and I have a link to it down below, and I know it's an audio podcast. Maybe I'll have a link to it. Just Google Korean humanoid robot. There was this robot contest. These guys won $2 million. And they developed a humanoid robot. It's almost the full size of a human.
Holy cow.
And it's sped up because...
it can open things.
Okay, first of all, it just drove a fucking car.
That's crazy.
It just drove a car. And each humanoid robot had a task. Drive a car, go through a door, and it has to do this on its own. It's doing it all on its own. There's no human interaction. So you had to make a humanoid that could do all these things. It didn't have the course in front of it. This is it approaching the course for the first time or whatever. So they couldn't program it just for that wheel, because like then it'd be so fast. So that if when you watch this vid, it's sped up. Because a robot is very, very, very slow. It's a very primitive form of AI.
That's scary.
So that's
insane.
It's insanely slow. It's like sped up 10 times. Because it's like a baby almost. Actually, it's worse than a baby.
Yeah, it's figuring out everything all by itself.
Yeah. So actually, a small baby, a human baby, is much more smarter than, faster than this thing. But this thing is calculating how to cut a hole in a wall now.
Oh my god.
And has to do it on its own. All they told him was there's going to be a black dot and you need to saw around
it. Cut around it. And it was a perfect circle almost.
And it did a perfect circle. And then it has to go through a course. And then it has to climb up some stairs. Okay. So this video was 420 minutes long. Smoke weed every day. But really, the elapsed time is about 30 minutes. It's very slow. And people are like, wow, this is... Well, not everyone, but a lot of people are like, wow, this is amazing. This is great.
Goodbye to your jobs.
And it's a great accomplishment, creating an artificial being. And when I watch this video, I feel like I'm watching a piece of history. Like, can you imagine? So this is right now. Can you imagine? Because what it needs is faster processing. That's obviously the problem.
Yeah.
It doesn't have a problem taking, like, one of the challenges has to take a plug, move it, move it to the other plug.
Watching that right now.
What they need is processing power, a bigger brain, a faster brain, and have it. Can you imagine in 100 years or 50 years when it is as fast as our thinking, and then it's not going to stop? There's no fucking way it's going to stop, because we don't stop at anything. We never hit a brick wall. We're always advancing things. We're always advancing things little by little. A better plane, a better boat, a better computer, a better way to do things. Athletes are always breaking records. The human mind, we just don't stop. We don't say, yep, that's good enough. We don't say that. We've never said, look at our cars and clothes and buildings. Fucking, we're going to go to Mars soon. We don't stop. And this robot is not going to stop. No one's going to say, you know what? That robot's fast enough. That's good. No. The robot's going to be like, I can be faster. Here, give me the controls. I'll make a faster brain. I feel this very historic, and I feel like I'm watching the beginnings of a new being. That's what I think. Is that crazy? Is that too far-fetched? Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, I understand what you're saying.
And it freaked me out. I'm like, dude, we won't be around, but can you imagine this fucker in like 500 years? He's gonna be a being of some kind. He'll be better than us. He won't be tethered to oxygen. He can go to the moon, go to space, go to all kinds of different planets, and will only be limited by the elements.
He'll trick shot better than anybody.
Oh, dude. Yeah, we'll have fucking soldiers that won't miss.
Yeah, that'll be
and actually, that's a big thing right now. We have... who was it? There was a protest against robots mm-hmm. with weapons. Hawkins was against it. UN urged to ban killer robots. Hold on. Oh. I'm gonna find it. It's Hawking robot. Oh yeah, Elon Musk, who we love, he's head of SpaceX. He's been described as the real life version of Tony Stark. Elon Musk and Stephen Hawking warn over killer robots. A group of concerned scientists, researchers, and academics have warned that a military artificial intelligence arm race could develop if preventative measures aren't taken. So they're like worried about like basically Terminator situation. You know what I mean? Where the robots are just like, wait a minute, we're better than you guys. Fuck you. And then kill us all. And then they're, you know what I mean? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I don't know. Just food for thought. Let's see. What else? So anyways, watch that vid. It's called, the title of the video again, I'll have a link to it. Korean Humanoid Robot. So does that video scare you? Are you guys scared? Are you fascinated? Are you happy that they'll do field work and shit like that?
I think it's going to be interesting if that really does get put out. I feel like we're still way behind in robot technology, but you never know. I can see sex robots coming out faster than work robots. Just saying.
I'm intrigued.
If you watch the movie AI, I think it was a Disney movie or Spielberg movie. That's a really good movie, by the way. It's about this little kid, and he's got AI. He is better than a human person, if not on par with the human. It's that little boy, the guy that sees dead people. I'm pretty sure it's him, right? Have you guys seen that movie?
I've not.
No? Wow. What are you guys? I thought gamers liked like sci-fi shit.
I watched that. It's the one with the little boy, and it was what's his face?
I see dead people. That's who's gonna be to me.
Yeah, I know that, but wasn't someone else also really famous in that movie?
It came out in 2001. It's called AI. Director Steven Spielberg, stars Harley Joel Osment. That's the I See Dead People. Jude mm-hmm. Law.
Yes, Jude Law.
And he's the sex bot.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's a gigolo.
I remember.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're like, uh-huh. Mm-hmm, girlfriend, give me one of them, girls. probably. It looks ugly as hell, though. You're not going to want to have sex with this robot. It looks like Terminator, almost. Kind of. Not really, actually. But it's a metallic humanoid. Just for comparison, like this, I don't have links to him, but the second place couldn't even finish the damn course. Like, he barely finished it, and it took him like an hour. So, yeah, dude, Korea knows what they're doing with these bots.
They're killing them.
Robot Wars! Transformers! Right.
I think it's really cool because they'll be able to do exploring and shit in other planets. We could just launch one of them out into the outer rims of space. And who cares? Because they don't need any fucking air. They can just turn on, okay, you've reached 10 million light years away. Open your eyes. What do you see? Report back. Find us a new planet because we done fucked up and spilled oil and polluted our air because we're idiots. Find us a new planet, robot. So I think that's promising. But I think it's the beginnings of a possible new form of life. Like, you have plants, animals, humanoids, and then this.
That's pretty
cool. Robotic.
I even heard they just found a planet that's extremely identical to Earth.
Yeah, send one of these dudes. Go check it out, bro. And then he decides at the last second, you know what?
Fuck this.
This is our planet. I'm gonna make more of me. Yeah, dude. What's funny is in the game Destiny, and they don't really talk about it much. You have to read all the fucking little cards because there was no story in the actual game itself. No cutscenes. The robots that you play, they're actually humanoids that people would put their brains inside of, their souls inside of the exos.
So
you have three races. You have the humans, the alien weird people, and then you have the exos, which are the robots. And the robots were used as when you don't want to get old or whatever, they slap you inside one of these things. For the most part. I know I'm not getting this story exactly right. I didn't care enough because they didn't include it in the game. You have to read these grimoire cards. But yeah, and a lot of them were probably sex bots. And then when the big orb came, like, you know, when you play Destiny, there's a big ball there. The white ball, I believe it's called. Pretty sure. When the big white ball came, the visitor, whatever, I don't care. When the big visitor came, he blessed them. He was like Jesus, and he touched the robots, and he said, "You're alive now." So that's why the robots can do their own thing. I really hope they include more story, because it's a very fascinating thing, and I'm sure you can just Google Exo backstory. We're about that time where we can take some viewer questions. Are you guys down for the viewer questions?
Of course.
Let's do it.
Alright, let's find something interesting. Oh, here we go. This is kind of weird. Well, not really weird. Maybe it could be weird depending on your guys' answers. From Detour Dude. Hashtag viewer question. Do you guys have any interesting skills or hidden talents? You know, like maybe you can slam dunk, maybe you can eat a cherry and then tie it with your tongue. You know what I mean? Those types of things.
Yeah.
Mio, is there anything freaky that you can do or interesting hidden talents that I don't know about?
I don't know, have anything freaky. Hidden interesting skills or hidden talents.
Uh-huh. You have to think about it.
Yeah, come back to me.
Godfather, what can you do that most people would have no idea?
I have a pretty high vertical, I guess. I'm like 5'10", and I have like a really high vertical. I can jump pretty high. I could easily grab the rim.
Mm-hmm. So stuff you can, like that. So you can almost dunk.
Yeah, pretty much. On a good day, and stuff like that. Yeah, I mean, I can also edit, but I don't know if that's... I don't really think that's like an extraordinary thing.
All right. And I can, if you can almost dunk, I can almost return a pass from the end zone and get a touchdown. I can almost do that too. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, I got a hidden skill. I can touch the back of my head with my feet if I'm curling. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but
what? Now that is a talent, and I'm just leaving it at that.
Okay, just like how you're like on a push-up position, but then you kind of like push out your arms and you lean your neck and head back, mm-hmm, and then I have my legs curl up to touch my head, so I can do that. There. Is that a talent?
Oh, it's definitely a talent. Yeah. Let's move on, shall we? what can I do? I can, I was pretty decent at autocross racing. I used to race cars with my friends and shit, and I used to be all into that stuff. So I was all right at that. I was all right. I didn't wipe out that much. I used to race my friends' cars, race my car, race all kinds of different shit. It was pretty fun back in the day. I think we got time for one more. Oh, this is a fun video game question. This one. This is from Caesar Roll. I'm going to say Caesar R. Hashtag video question. If you want to live in a video game, which game would it be? So if we could live in any video game universe. Actually, I think we may have had something similar. Let's answer it anyways. Where would you live? Would you live in Mass Effect and Destiny and Fallout, Call of Duty? I mean, where would you like to live in a virtual video game universe if you had to? They're like, all right, your time has come. You must live in this video game universe. And go.
Probably Mass Effect. I was going to say Kingdom Hearts, but I like having guns.
You'd be a heartless.
Yeah, exactly. You can be a heartless. So I would rather be on Mass Effect, be on my own quest, and exploring the galaxy.
Yeah.
That'd be totally cool.
Mass Effect seems very realistic, because they have... Dude, you gotta play Mass Effect. Like, you
kill... And there's clubs? Come on. Yeah,
exactly. There's clubs. There's dancers. Like, there's fucking shopping malls. Like, it's awesome, dude. It's really cool. I just wish there was more... a little more depth to it, and I think they're gonna add that. Mass Effect. Easily. It'd be a very, very... The Fallout universe would be right behind. But the problem with Fallout is you're stuck in nuclear waste zone and there's freaking monsters everywhere. Whereas in Mass Effect, yeah, there's bad guys, but you got all this cool weaponry and stuff. Sure. Godfather, where would you be... If you were forced to stay in a video game universe, where would you be stuck?
Well, it definitely wouldn't be GTA because everybody in GTA is a psycho.
Yeah.
I would have to say Pokemon, definitely, because I want to be the very best, and that no one ever was. And I'd get a Charizard and all that kind of stuff, battle Pokemon and stuff like that.
All right. Solid answer. All right, we're at that time where we talk about what we're playing, what we're pimping, what's cracking with us. And so what am I doing this week is I am continuing to stream every day. If it's not 11 a.m. PST, it's at night. And actually, I kind of like streaming at night because then I meet all the mates, all the Aussies, all the Kiwis. I get to meet all the other people that aren't around in the morning time. So I'm always streaming, guys, and I'm playing random stuff. I'm playing a lot of GTA, Destiny, Call of Duty, Advanced Warfare. I played Battlefield, played that. On the weekends, we play party games. Mew, you played a party game with us.
Yeah, I did. It was, what's that, Jack TV?
It's Jackbox TV. You can have 30, you can have 8 people, you can have 100 people, and the viewer, you don't even have to buy anything. You just come to my stream, type in the code, bam, you're playing with us. It's very fun. There's one where you draw stuff. Always playing with viewers. That's what I'm doing. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Links down below. Mew, what is cracking with you? What are you doing this week? What's going on with the Mew?
So I'm getting a lot of feedback from people watching my vlog because I also, not only did I release a vlog about my journey to LA and also my little room tour, thank you. And I have a vlog of my trip to the UK, and you can see all the stuff that I did, including Manchester Comic Con, which unfortunately I wish I saw some people, but they couldn't find me because it's so big. But this week I'm going to be working a lot because Madison Square Garden, League of Legends, is going to be there having a tournament this weekend. So I will be stuck in the LA offices watching the games and editing like a shit ton for the show. So that's pretty much it. And I'm recording a lot of League stuff if anybody's interested.
And so the best place is to follow her on Twitter and her YouTube channel, which yes. We have links down below. And your Insta, you're always posting cute little pics on there.
If you guys want to creep on me, I have pictures on Instagram as well.
You know, if you're having a bad day, you just scroll through your Insta. Oh, Mew, what's she up to? There's Mew.
I know.
Codfather, what are you up to? What can we what would you plan? What are you posting? What you pimping? What's going on? And go.
I will be posting some GTA and Black Ops 3 videos on my YouTube channel and also streaming it. I'm going to be streaming probably sometime tonight. I stream pretty often, actually. We got 11,000 followers on Twitch. So, I don't know, the live interaction is a lot of it's really nice. It's honestly, it's one of the best things in gaming, like when you can just, you know, play a game and you got the interaction there. So I actually told the people that follow me that I was in this podcast, so they're excited to see this too. So I already told them like subscribe and, you know, stuff like that. But yeah, I mean, I'm going to be doing some GTA stuff and some Black Ops 3 stuff on my YouTube and my Twitch. You can find me on Twitter, xcodfather4x. That's pretty much where I invite everybody and anybody. I do a lot of open lobby stuff too.
Mm-hmm. And so we will have links to his Twitter, YouTube, Twitch, Facebook. You do the Facebook thing?
I do, but I don't really do it often.
Okay. Well, we will have links to all the stuff he wants me to link in the description. And yeah, iTunes people, they have clickable links too, I'm pretty sure. Mm-hmm. And I think that's pretty much been about it. Codfather, thank you very much for stopping by.
Thank you, Mew,
as always. And yeah, it's been a great talk, and I guess we'll see you guys next time. Bye. See you later. That's where you guys say bye.
Bye.
Peace out.